Good evening, everyone. I'm Nathan, here with my wonderful wife, Laura.
Hello.
And we're here to take a look at and quick review of the Popstars board game based on the television show.
We sure are. So, Popstars. If you don't remember it, it was like a talent search show before Australian Idol, I think, came
about. Or American Idol.
Well, I think it was about the same time, maybe, somewhere back there. But basically, people who could sing would go and audition, and they ended up putting together a couple of bands.
Oh, they were so scandalous.
Well, that was Series 2, in Australia anyway. I think this board game originated after Season 1.
So there's Bardot.
Yes, after Bardot was formed. Let us know if you remember Bardot.
It's based on the chart-topping television series. You've got to form a band or get people, equipment, contract to record it, and then you see where your song ends up in the charts.
Well, you have to get to the top of the charts. We are missing one thing. There is meant to be a karaoke CD in here. However, we wouldn't be able to kind of play any of that for you anyway, because they are mainstream sort of songs, and we'd be in trouble probably.
And it also completely, spoiler, does not affect the game in any way.
It sure doesn't. So let's open it up and let you see inside. All right, so first we have here the instructions.
We will have a link to them down below.
Just in case you find the game and you're missing the instructions. That is it though. What you see.
A single.
So turn over, yeah. What you see is what you get there.
So we have our board.
Mm-hmm. So there are several rings in the middle of the board. I think we've got that upside down, but never mind. There's three rings that you work your way around in the center, and then the outside of the board here you can see is numbered. That is your position in the charts. So you have to get from 40 up to 1. And again, we do have the board upside down, sorry.
Yes.
We also have spaces here for all of our decks of cards.
I'm not impressed with this game. I don't know if you can tell from my overall tone.
You'll see why. All right, so you've also got some lyrics.
For the karaoke CD, there is 11 of them, I think.
I think so.
So it starts from 2 because you roll 2 dice, you can't get a 1 with 2 dice.
Yes, so the dice determine which song you need, which we'll get to later. It also comes with these cards where you can, like, order some of their other games.
I think this is pretty apt, I think, about this game. Sorry, I covered the fact part.
Okay, so some of our cards have escaped here. But these are the player card guides. So everyone at the start of the game picks the colour they're going to be. So say I was going to be orange, I would get the orange player card guide. It shows the different stages that are in the middle circle section of the board.
Auditions, forming the band, and the record release, which you need to
record and release,
which you need to do before you can go into the charts, obviously.
Yes, so they are all double-sided and match each of the playing pieces, which, as you saw, are just sort of standard.
Can you imagine having 6 people playing this?
I can imagine. So up to 6 players if you have that many people who want to join in with the Popstars board game.
And this comes with 3 dice. 2 regular die, 1 to 6, and a chart dice, which tells you if you go up the charts, down the charts, or you do not move positions.
Yes. So then you have different coloured star cards. I can't remember if they have a name. I mean, they've got stars on the back, but
Should we just set up the board with them on there and sort of... Sure. It's probably easier to show how it works.
So let's bring the board back in. So say I'm orange and you can pick a colour.
Yeah. Pink, because pink goes fast.
Okay. So you start in this outer ring here. This one says auditions on the start space, which is the arrow over here.
I can't remember what colour you said. You're blue now.
Okay, sure, that's not confusing at all. So you'll get the cards, and they obviously need to be shuffled, and then each go on their corresponding space.
We'll just put a couple on each one, just as a sort of...
We have white ones that are chance ones here as well. All right, some chance ones. And we'll show you what these are in a moment. So you start on here, you would roll the dice, and you want to make your way around the circle in a clockwise direction.
Oh, we should start with our cards, huh?
Yeah, so we're not going to do a full playthrough of this because it actually can take quite a while.
And it's very monotonous. So
you're pink.
I'm pink.
Yep. So as you work your way around the circle, it depends on what you land on. If you land on a coloured space, you're going to pick a corresponding coloured card.
That doesn't match. I thought
Nathan was going to say something, but no, he didn't.
So I pick it up. I go, is that a pink card? No. And I actually can keep this one because it actually is part of the auditions
loop. So as you can see, the auditions cards have microphones and like group outlines, I'm going to call them.
I guess so. You know, you form, you get the people for your band,
yeah,
or whatever.
Yeah. So you have to collect one of everything that you see here. So in this case, you need 5 of the band ones and 1 microphone. That's not Nathan's colour though, and you have to get it in the correct colour.
Yes.
So that doesn't help you in any way.
It does not.
If someone was playing as orange, like I attempted to before, Nathan could then hold on to that. And if he landed on trade, could look at trading that with the person who needs that particular colour. However, orange isn't playing.
Nope.
So it's completely useless.
So it goes back in the bottom.
It does have a tip at the end of the instructions. You can just remove all the colours that someone isn't playing as. We obviously haven't done that just for this example.
And there's actually quite a few cards. I think this is the majority of them.
Mm-hmm.
And that's just 1 of 4 decks. So if you're only playing with 2 players, that's actually quite a lot of extra busy work you need to do just before you even start playing.
Yes. So we would continue making our way just around and around this circle until we find the ones we need. So, I mean, obviously no one was green. This symbol does not match the auditions line, so we have to put that straight back. It's no use to anybody.
You can only get the cards in the ring you're in.
Mm-hmm. Which again, as you can see, can take quite a while. I mean, obviously I'm only looking in one deck here, but there's the first one there that's, you know, helpful. And again, no one's playing as purple.
Hey, do you know what you do? Once you fill up all these ones here, do you know what you do?
Yeah, so once you get all of your cards, you move into the second ring.
And what else do you do? Oh, wait, you have to get more cards from forming the band.
You sure do, all in your own colour. So you then make your way around the second ring, matching your forming the band row of cards, all in your colour.
You get all them.
I was going to say, you can also continue to trade in that one if you collect something that is in someone else's colour who is playing for the band that they're on. You can hold on to it and trade if you land on the trade space. Then you move into the third ring.
And you move into the third ring.
Guess what you're doing there?
You keep going round and round using 2 dice to move a very small amount of spaces to get the record and release ring filled up with your cards.
Yes, so you do the same thing 3 times. It can get quite monotonous. We've played with just the 2 of us and it took a while.
I think we did 1 ring and then we went straight to the charts.
Yeah, we were like, all right, we've had get enough. It. Yeah, playing with 6, I think you would have to clear an afternoon, really.
Oh.
Anyway, so once you get all of your cards, either by picking them up or via trading, you go 40. To number 40 in the chart ring. Now,
here's where
karaoke
So basically, you roll the dice.
Mm-hmm.
I got 8. I'd look
so
for
you
the,
add them together.
Add them together. I'd look for the one that says A, which is here, which I'd be singing. Oh, Ricky Martin. So then you'd put the karaoke CD in, you'd then bang out
track 8.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And then nothing happens.
Yeah, so Nathan would have to sing that full song while the other players sit and listen.
To my excellent singing.
Yes, fun. After that happens, essentially you just move around the outer ring of the board. Now that's determined with one of the numbered dice.
One of the numbered dice and the... So basically after I've sung a song, I go, okay, I got 5 and I went up.
5 positions.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Now, you don't have to sing any more songs, you just do the one at the start of the charts.
And it doesn't affect anything else. The next turn, instead of singing a song, I just roll the dice.
Yep, doesn't matter whether you sing really well, whether you stuff up the words.
There's no voting or anything.
No, it's just fun, I guess.
Yeah, fun.
So then you move around the outer circle with, outer edge, with the intent of reaching number 1. But there's a few things along the way that might slow you down.
Yeah, so basically if you land on any of the white stars, you pick up a chance card.
You do. These can either send you forward or backwards, or occasionally can send someone else forward or backwards.
Smash hit. You wear a rival band's t-shirt on stage at a concert and then rip it to shreds. Whoa. What a sourpuss. Go back 4 spaces or move someone else forward 3.
Right, so Nathan would then have to go 1, 2.
Or move you forward if you happen to be in the charts.
Yep. you do that until you reach one. The only other thing around the edge that you can land on is number 13 over here. Ooh, oh, which how is just, unlucky is
which
that?
Which is just a complete dud of a space. It sends you back to 40 in the charts.
Yep, and not only that, but if you land here, you have to go back to 40 and sing another song off the karaoke CD. So you'd roll again, find your number and sing.
So they're saying that this karaoke is actually punishment.
Well, almost, yeah. I mean, you're going back to the start of the
And the only other time that you have to sing the karaoke song.
Yes, and again, the actual song or how well you do has no bearing on the game whatsoever.
I'm just going to go back to the chance. All they do is usually move you forward back a couple of spaces. There's no sort of...
They have like a little
funny
description
sort of,
about them.
You know, you're in like four magazines at once. Ooh, go forward two spaces, things like that. So yeah.
So I mean, you can pause and kind of read some of these if you wanted to.
Oh, media darling, you're chosen as one of the most 50 most beautiful people of the year. You glamour puss. Ooh.
They're all over the place, as you can see. But again, feel free to pause and have a read. I think there's a couple
blank
ones.
Sorry, we said there's only two ways to sing. This one, Music Awards. You win Hottest New Act for the Year, go forward, five spaces, or pick a person, roll the dice, and sing a song on the karaoke CD.
Which doesn't sound like it affects the gameplay at all. Anyway.
You go around, you get to number one, and then you basically put the game away and don't play it again.
Yes. Yeah.
This is...
It's long, it's tedious. I get the idea, because obviously Pop Stars was... a fairly good, popular TV show of the time. But it's that circle Nathan's pointing out that kind of...
Look, if they had just had the charts and the sing karaoke and things like that and maybe simplified this, I could see it.
Yeah.
But this particular minute, doing it three times is just beyond ridiculous.
Especially with this quantity of cards. Obviously, we said you can take out the colours that you're not playing as, but then if you were playing with everybody... This would be what you had to work your way through to try and find quite a lot of cards every round.
And
so,
this comes down to luck, a little bit maybe if you land on trade, but it's all just...
On that note, if you did land on trade, as we said, you can swap with someone if they've got a card they've held on to that they didn't need, but, you know, that can be helpful. However, say I landed on trade and I had... what colour were you? Pink. So I had a pink one that Nathan needed, and... I didn't have a pink one, but he had the one I needed. My mistake. I can swap with him, even if I'm giving him someone else's coloured card, as long as I'm getting the one that helps me.
So you can trade me any crud that I don't need, as long as you get something you need back in return.
As long as it's from the same ring, because you can't keep them from different rings.
Look, I've got a,
complicated.
I've got to know, out of the probably three people that bought this... Has anyone actually played it to the full? Has anyone actually gone all the way through the rings, sung the karaoke, went all the way around?
I don't know. I'm sure there were many. This is not one I remember. I did not know this existed, and I religiously watched Pop Stars back in the day when it was on in Australia.
I think you dodged a bullet there. I don't like this game.
We can tell. I'm not sure if we showed kind of all of the Rick songs Martin. That are on it. They're all obviously...
Venga Boys.
Very much of what was popular at the time. And as I think we did mention, one of the Bardot songs, I think it's Poison is in here, is it?
Was that that was the dud one? That wasn't their...
No, so Poison was the debut single from Bardot, because Bardot won the first series of Pop Stars Australia. So this was before Scandalous won, and well, not won, but came through the second series. So, and before the third series with Scott Cain. I don't know what I'm talking about. I remember watching it all.
Well, let us know if you not just if you played the game, but if you obviously watched Pop Stars back in the day.
Awesome back then. But if you enjoyed watching this video, give us a thumbs up. Let us know. We've asked a few questions. Feel free to answer any one of them or all of them in the comments. Hey, hit that subscribe button and check back soon. We have videos every single Tuesday.
Sounds good.
Thanks for watching.
Bye-bye.